Okay. Om. Shuklam Varadaram Vishnum Sashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasannavadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vigno Pashantaye Dorbiryukta Chaturbhir Spatikamanimai Makshamalam Tathana Hastenaikena Padmam Sitamapicha Shukam Pustakam Chaparena Bhasa Kundendu Shankas Patikamaninibha Bhasamana Samana Same Vagdevateyam Nivasatu Vasane Sarvada Suprasanna Kujantam Rama Rameti Madhuram Madhuraksharam Aruhya Kavita Shakam Vande Valmiki Kokilam Valmikir Munisimhasya Kavita Vanacharinaha Shrinvan Rama Katanatam Konayati Param Gatim Goshpati Kritavarashim Mashaki Kritarakshasam Ramayana Mahamala Ratnam Vande Nilatmajam Yatra Yatra Ragunata Kirtanam Tatra Tatra Kritamastakanjalim Bashpavari Paripurna Lochanam Marutim Namatarakshasantakam Vaidehi Sahitam Suradrumatale Haime Mahamandape Madhye Pushpakamasane Manimaye Virasane Sustitam Agrevachayati Prabhanjanasute Tattvam Munibhyaparam Vyakhyantam Bharata Dibiparivritam Ramam Vajeshyamalam Namostu Ramaya Salakshmanaya Devyai Chatasyai Janakatmajayai Namostu Rudrendra Yamanilebhyo Namostu Chandrarka Marudganebhyaha Harihi Om. Okay, so last class we ended with a beautiful sarga, if you remember, where Rama was telling Bharata. In fact, I think it was exactly the chapter 2 of first part of chapter 2 of Bhagavad Gita. Identical message, identical set of things which Rama told Bharata, and we were making this remark that when we face very difficult things in life, so that was common between the first 15 shlokas in chapter 2, that is when Krishna started, shloka 11 to 30 in Bhagavad Gita, and that sarga which we saw, 105th sarga that we saw in Ayodhya Kandam, has something very common. What is that? If we face something extraordinarily difficult, what should we do? See, we face small little difficulties. Yaral agamapayino anityaha. That is okay. But if we really face something very hard, you know, Arjuna faced something which was quite difficult. You know, you have to finish off all your grandfather and, you know, cousins, uncles. That's not easy by any stretch of imagination. Even on a hypothetical sense, we cannot do it. So that was his problem. And Bharata is facing a very similar problem. In his absence, his mother did something foolishly, at least in his opinion. And even before he came, the father is dead. And the whole of Ayodhya thinks Bharata stage managed. Bharata is a very difficult character. Everybody he met, he is only pleading them that I didn't want any of this. What a pity for him. He also finds a situation which is extremely difficult to handle. he doesn't want to be the king. Rama is already in the forest. So it's a very complex situation. So the messages are very identical. We ended with that message, if you remember, when we finished the 105th Sarga. There are clear messages, you know, understand the notion of time, understand the basic pravritti of dharma. There are 3-4 messages which are identical between that Sarga and Bhagavad Gita's that 15-20 shlokas. We stopped there. So the conversation continues because that's the end of Ayodhya Kandam. Bharata has come. Bharata is hell-bent to take Rama back. That is why he brought all the elders, he brought the army, everything. He wanted to persuade and somehow request Rama to come back. So that hasn't even started actually. He just made an opening remark and immediately Rama told, you know, what do you think of two brothers? It's like these two logs of water. Some beautiful shlokas are there in 105th Sarga. It's like two logs of kashtam, kashtam cha, that shloka. You know, it is like two logs which travel in a river. Suddenly the two logs just get together and then it looks like they balance with each other and keep on moving. After a while, the two logs just go out. So life is like that. What to make sense of all these? There are larger principles of dharma. So this is what Rama was trying to tell Bharata and advises Bharata, therefore you go back. I think there is a Bhagavad Leela which is much larger than you and I can comprehend. Therefore, it would be sensible to do what our ancestors were doing. Father has said something, you must carry on. So that's where we stopped last time. And Bharata is not yet ready. Bharata is not convinced because he feels Rama, this rightfully belongs to Rama. Therefore, somehow he should convince Rama. So he, in this Sarga, 106th Sarga, he brings a few arguments, one or two we will see. And then Jabali comes and says something. Then Vasistha comes and says something. All these are there. So we will see some of those today. So 106th Sarga, which has about 35 verses. After Rama spoke this nice Vedantic thought, told him, don't jump too much. Things have happened. Gracefully accept it and then go. Then Bharata still is not convinced. So in the first 13 shlokas, he again says, you know, I was not even in the scene. My mother did all these, which were completely wrong. The father also, I think, got into this wrong understanding of what should be done. I should have punished my mother. That's all he says. He says, I should have punished my mother. But I am bound by dharma, that's why I am keeping quiet. I mean, it's a certain emotion that he is actually bringing. And all that he says in those 13 shlokas. And then he goes on to give different arguments to... He gives three arguments. I have taken one or two of them, which are interesting. He gives two, three arguments to say, Rama, no, all that you taught me, told me all this, but I think you should come back. And you should rule the kingdom. He advances a few arguments. And towards the end of the chapter, he says, we will do the Pattabhishega here in the forest. Right away we will do. Let us not, because there can be many a slip between the cup and the lip. Let us not give chance for any of those. Right away we will do Pattabhishega. Then we will go to Ayodhya. We will do everything here. That shows his genuine anxiety. And genuine feeling that this whole thing rightfully belongs to Rama. By some sort of things, it has come up to him. That beautifully Bharata brings again and again in the Ayodhya Kandam we have been seeing. In the 79th Sarga we have been seeing. Ever since he came to Ayodhya, he doesn't miss this at all. Every opportunity he keeps seeing. So we'll see some shlokas from this chapter.
Yata mritas tata jivan, yata sati tata sati,
yasyaish buddhi labhasyat paritapyeta kena sah. He just turned the table to Rama. What Rama said, he just turned back to him. That's what he is trying here. So what is he saying here? Yata mritaha tata jivan. Somebody is dead, somebody is living. Correct? So somebody is dead, somebody is living. Yata mritaha tata, like that, somebody is living. Tata jivan. Yata asati, avagraha is the akara there. Yata asati tata sati. Somebody is sat, somebody is asat. Virtuous, not virtuous. So he says, somebody is living, somebody is not living. Somebody is a satpurusha, somebody is not a satpurusha. Like this, there are differences there in life. We see all the good, bad, all dvandva we always see. I like it, I don't like it. This is good, this is not good. This is hot, this is cold. This is sukha, this is dukkha. You can put a whole list of dvandvas, dualities. So he is given only two examples. What he is trying to say is, you are dvandvatita. He is telling to Rama, you are beyond duality. You have mastered, you have developed that titiksha. You have gone beyond this world of opposites. Because for ordinary people, the world of opposites affects us. Sukha also affects us. How? Because the loss of sukha affects us. Dukkha anyway affects us. So he says he is beyond all this. That's what he is bringing here by giving these two examples. Yasya, for such a person, yeshaha buddhi labha syat. This is all they have understood through that buddhi. All this doesn't matter. Somebody who is able to say all these are fine. Yasya buddhi labha syat, kena saha paritapyate. What can bother him? What kind of a thing can bother him? Therefore, all that has happened, right or wrong, don't worry, don't bother. You should not bother about it. You should come back. So that's where he is coming now. He's saying, you are beyond all this. So why are you taking sides? You go beyond that. All this has happened. Let us not analyze even whether it is right or wrong. Because you are such a person. There are two, three shlokas around that. He says, you are a person who is beyond all this. He's preparing all that to say, therefore, you, why are you looking at all these Vedas? Things have happened. So let us not worry whether father right, father wrong. Let us not do all that. You come. So that is the first simple argument he actually makes. Then he says, proshite mayi yat papam matra matkaranat kritam kshudraya tadanishtam me prasidatu bhavan mama. Proshite mayi, I was sent. I was in my uncle's place. Proshite mayi sati yat papam matra kritam. My mother did that wrong thing. Matkaranat, thinking it is for my good. Matkaranat matra yat papam kritam kshudraya, with haste, without thoughtlessly, without thinking through the consequences, because the consequences have already happened. The father is dead. Dasharatha could not take the shock. He just passed away. So kshudraya tad anishtam me, ishtam na anishtam. This is not to my liking. I am not at all party to this. I didn't like any of these. These are all my mother's making. She thought she will do it for me. Tad anishtam me bhavan prasim mama prasidatu. Please, you know, forgive me or something. Do anugraha of me by undoing all these that has happened. All these has happened already. You please, undo all these. That way, you know, you will be able to, you know, pardon me in a very gracious way. So this is the first argument. He says, you are beyond the world of plus and minuses. So why I have to look at the plus and minus? You'll go beyond all that. You just come and then take care of the reins of Ayodhya. This is one set of argument Bharata made.
Sadvartam abhisandhaya krodhan mohacha sahasat tatasya yadadikrantam pratyaharatu tadbhavan. Tatasya yata atikrantam. Atikrantam is going beyond the limits. Crossing the limits, na? Atikrantam. So, yata tatasya atikrantam. Father did something which was not correct. He need not have done this. Because Kaikeyi asked and all that he did. Tatasya yata atikrantam
And why did he do? He could have done because of krodha or moha or sahasat. One of the three. Anger or delusion or recklessness. He would have done just like that. Or out of anger. Or out of delusion. Father has clearly crossed. He need not have done it. He did it. Right? Tat sadhuartham abhisandaya. Sadhu artham abhisandaya. Thinking properly. Rightly. Sadhu artham abhisandaya. Pratyaharatu. Nivarayatu. Sort it out. What has happened has happened. He has done out of anger or delusion or whatever. But father has clearly crossed. He could have done many things. Why did he do it? Therefore, think carefully, properly, and why don't you sort it out? Why don't you sort it out? Roll it back. That is what he is saying. Pitur hi samati, and he gives an example. He gives a quotes a certain smriti also there. Some smriti, Vedic injunction. Pitur hi samati krantam. Putro yasadhu manyate tadapatyam matam loke viparitam atonyata. Pituhu hi samatikrantam putraha yaha sadhu manyate. If for some reason the father or the mother, pituhu means parents, we can take. The father or mother did something which was probably not the appropriate thing. Tasya sadhu manyate. To really take an effort to sort it out, to rectify it, right? Tat apatyam matam loke. That is what is really known as a son or an offspring. The offspring's primary responsibility is actually this. So he is sort of soft blackmailing him by bringing this kind of smriti injunctions actually. So tat apatyam matam loke. Loke, I am not saying. This is a worldly wisdom. See, Chittaranjan Das, the great lawyer, his father left a lot of debt. He sorted out all of them. He had enormous sense of satisfaction that the apavada of my father I have removed. That is the thing. You know, there could have been situations, there could have been, we do not know. You know, when you run a family, so many things, you know, everything is... there's a karma. Karma is driving everything. So Chittaranjan Das spent all his effort, I was reading somewhere, to make sure that his father's apavada is removed. So that is the thing he is saying. So father has done something. But a person is called son only when he is sorting it out. So he's soft blackmailing him, you know, by saying like that. Then he says, viparitam ataha. Anyata. If you don't do it, people don't think you as a son. You are not a worthy son anymore. You should not leave it like that. You should sort it out. So therefore, for that reason, you better come. You have to, otherwise you will not be counted in as a son because that is not a loka vahara. Something like that he is trying to sort of. So this is another argument that he made.
Kvacharanyam kvachakshatram kvachajata kvachapalanam idrisham vyahatam karma nabhavan kartum arhati.
What is all these? You are in a forest. Kvacharanyam. You are sitting somewhere in the forest. You are supposed to be a king. You are the Jeshta Putra. So, you know, rightfully the lineage comes to the elder son in dynastic sort of things. What is all this? You are in a forest. Kocha aranyam, kocha kshatram. You are a kshatriya. What happened to your kshatra? That your responsibility to protect and take care of the larger things of the society. What happened to that? Kocha kshatram, kojataha. All these jatadara and all that. What is all going on here? Kvacha jataha, kvacha palanam. Who is going to protect? You are a kshatriya, you are the eldest, right? And you have left all of them, you are here, with all these jata in these forests. Idrisham vyahatam karma. This is all antithetical, these are all repulsive. No, this is not what it is. Because when you are in position, you cannot just take position just because something happened. You cannot take positions like that. So he says, Idrisham Vyagritam Karma Nabhavan Kartu Marhati. I don't think it is fit for you to do this. Don't do that. This is not what it is. You are ordained to do not this. Because you are a Kshatriya, you are the Jeshtaputra, and Palanam, you know, Praja Paripalanam is your responsibility. What are you doing? This is another angle. He came from another angle and tried to persuade him.
Then, Yesha hi pratamo dharmaha kshatriyasya bishechanam yena shakyam maha prajna prajanam paripalanam.
He is now talking kshatriya dharma. In that sloka only he continues in the 19th sloka. He says, Yesha hi pratamo dharmaha kshatriyasya. This is the number one, the most important dharma of a kshatriya. What is that? Prajanam paripalanam, which is coming in the second line. Prajanam paripalanam is actually the number one responsibility of a king to be. Correct? So, in order to do that, abhishecham, you have to get that mandate, no? You have to get the power of attorney or the power to do things. That is abhishecham. That's why he says, Eshahi pratamo dharmaha kshatriyasya abhishechanam yena shakyam mahapragnya prajanam. That abhishechana enables you. Yena, that yena is the abhishechanam. By virtue of getting coronated, you are empowered. Empowered for what? Prajanam paripalanam. And Valmiki, not only Valmiki, all kavis you must see. Look at the adjective for Rama here. It says, mahapragnya. Nya, the ending of nya in Sanskrit means no. Prajnana, you know, prakrishtena jnatam, which means he is well informed. Maha, and then puts one more adjective on the top of it, mahapragnya. He is telling him, you know everything I am now telling you. Mahapragnya is the adjective for Rama. He is saying, you know everything. Prajna itself is, prakrishtena jnatam. Then he puts on maha also on the top of it to make it even more heavy. He says, you are a knower of everything. Why are you not doing it? Let's say that is the adjective for Rama here. Mahapragna is the sambodhana for Rama. Hey Rama, why are you doing like this? Your pratama dharma is do abhishechana, get empowered and prajanam paripalanam. So in this argument, he took the kshatriya dharma as the basis to argue. Earlier he said, you are a son. Don't give up your, people will then say you are not a son. So it's a soft blackmailing which he did. First argument, he said, no, you are beyond all these pluses and minuses. Why are you looking at all these differences? Leave it all of them. Come. That's the third argument he made. Then, chaturnam ashranam ashramanam hi garhastyam sreshtam uttamam ahur dharmajna dharmajna tam katam tyaktum arhasi. Again, look at the adjective for Rama, dharmajna, one who knows dharma. He is just catching him by what he knows. You know dharma, now I will tell you dharma. Okay? So dharmajna, right, that's what his sambodhana there. Chaturnam ashramanam ki garhastam sreshtam uttamam. Of the four ashramas, right? See, the word ashrama, right? The word ashrama in Sanskrit essentially means a resting place. We have to first understand this. Ashrama is a resting place. What does it mean? That means you cannot be a brahmachari forever. It's a transit house. It's like a transit house. You can be a brahmachari only up to the age of 20, 22 max. Right? You can't be a grihastha until you die. That's why it's called ashrama. It is a transient place. Then you have vanaprastha. Again, you can't be permanent there. Then sannyasa. This is how the sojourn of an individual. See, in this country, Sanatana Dharma has so beautifully laid out. Sanatana Dharma has a two-dimensional axis. One axis is take an individual, that individual from womb to tomb. How do they move? from the mother's womb to the tomb, how do they move? That is one axis. That is called ashrama. Every one of us must first go to brahmacharya, then grihastha ashram, then vanaprastha, then sannyasa. So that is one axis. Then in Sanatana Dharma, we have taken another axis, which is called Varna Dharma. Individual, every individual will live and then one day will pass off. But that individual also do some work. So our positioning is on a two-dimensional matrix. We can be in one of the Varnas, and we have to be, having taken the Varna, we have to have an ashrama. We have to move. So this is how the whole thing is fixed. So it is a movement on any one of the four tracks. The four Varnas are for what kind of a profession you want to do. That is given by the Varna. Whatever profession you are, every one of us have to go through a brahmachari, you know, grihastha ashram and all that. Here he says, Bharata is saying, Dharmajna, you know Dharma, but I will tell you, Chaturnam ashramanam, of the four ashramas, Garhastam, which is a grihastha ashrama, Shrestham and Uttamam. That is the best and the ultimate, right? Right? Ahuhu Dharmajnaha. Dharmajnaha. I think this Dharmajnaha, we have to take that. Ahuhu Dharmajnaha. Known people who know Dharma actually say that. Then he says, hey, Dharmajnaha, katam tyaktum arhati. The first Dharmajnaha is for Rama. The second Dharmajnaha is the plural. For those who are the knower of Dharma. That's how those are coming. So he says, Grihastha Ashrama is the ultimate. You are now sitting like a Vanaprastha. That's what he is saying. He is now coming there. He is saying at this age, you have to be a Grihastha Ashrami. You are now sitting in the Vana, then you are like a Vanaprastha. No, no. Come here. So that's the next argument he is saying. He is trying all possible ways. Okay.
Atai tat prishtata kritva vanameva bhavanitaha gamishyati gamishyami bhavata sadam apyaham.
Finally, he gives the final bullet, which is a straight blackmail. After all arguments, Bharata made one final blackmail. What is he saying? Ata. Even after all this, etat prishtataha kritva, all that I told, if you just leave it behind, you're not going to listen to what I say. You don't think that's what it is. Right? Vanameva bhavan itaha gamishyati. If you say, no, no, I will go to the vana only. He says, bhavata sadharmyam aham gamishyami. I will also come to the forest now. So this is a straight blackmail. Earlier it was soft blackmail. This is a straight blackmail. He said, okay, all that I have said, if you are not going to listen, and you are going to just discard all of them, prishtataha kritva, you just leave it behind, and then say, no, no, I am going on to the forest, I will also come with you. So this is how he sort of tries some 3-4 possible ways by which he is trying to persuade Rama, right? Now I want to talk a little bit about the grihastha ashram, because this is my favorite topic. I believe that this has been grossly misunderstood nowadays. So I went into a little bit of Smriti Granthas, Manusmriti, and some Vyasa Smriti, one of Yajnavalkya Smriti also is there, but I just took only a little bit. Just to tell you, what was this whole plan which was laid out, which you have missed today? Today, nobody knows what is Grihastha Ashrama. Somebody gets married. Then they think marriage is equal to Grihastha Ashrama. So something like that, they put a rough mapping between the two. While on the surface, that is correct. But we should understand the original intent of how it is. So I thought I will take a few shlokas from Smritis just to show you how they have laid out and why this is very important. First of all, why is Grihastha Ashrama important? Let us look at Vyasa Smriti, what it says. It says, Yavan Navindate Jayam Tavadardo bhavet puman nardham prajayate sarvam prajaye tetyapi shrutihi. Yavat na vindate jayam. If a person does not get a wife, yavat na vindate jayam, tavat ardo bhavet puman. He is only half. 50%. That's all. That's what, you know, and that's actually, there are quite a few things to explain it. It will get too long for me to get into it. But essentially, he says, Nardam Prajayate Sarvam. Right? Prajayate Ityapi Shrutihi. Not only the offsprings, nothing you can get without the better half. Nothing. Nothing is possible without a better half. So if you don't have a better half, you are only half. That's what Vyasa Smriti is saying. But look at the Panchatantra, brings it much better. Why it is, many shlokas are there. I took the Panchatantra. Rina seshas chagni seshaha shatru seshas tataivacha puna puna pravartante tasma chesham nar rakshayet. What a powerful message you see. It says there are four debts which will not die. It will only come again and again. First is the debt that you took, your financial dealings. You took some money, you know, interest and interest and interest. You know, if you don't repay, the principal will be intact and you may pay interest. You know, that is a renunciation. Agni seshaya. If there is a big fire, don't put off 98% fire and go back home. It's just an half an hour, all the effort will be vyartha. Agni sesha, we can never leave. It has to be complete nirvapanam. That is one meaning. There's another meaning to the Agni Sesha. If you are Karmakandi, then if the Vedic injunctions, if the Vedic injunctions are to be done, Agni is the only medium, Agni is the only wealth that you carry. So if you don't, then all those karmas are pending for you. So that is another way to understand Agni Sesha. In a day-to-day world, Agni Sesha means that you can't leave fire like that and go. It will come back with twice the vigor. That's why fire is called Analaha in Sanskrit. Na alam iti Analaha. Whatever you give, he says, not enough. Give me enough. Give me even more. I will consume. That's why the Sanskrit word for Agni is Analaha. Right? Water is Anilaha. Agni is Analaha. Na alam iti Analaha. So that is Agni Sesha. Shatru Sesha. Chanakyaniti, if you read, you will understand. If you leave some people who are against you, we don't know which way it is going to come back again. That's what he says. Shatru Shesha is also not good. Tataivacha. Punaha punaha pravartante. Tasmat sesham narakshaye. No, the Rana Sesha also, not the financial debt. There is something called Pitra Rana. There is something called Pitra Rana. That's why in Taittiriya Upanishad, I keep quoting it again and again. He says, you know, in that, this thing, you know, Vedam Anuchya Acharya Antevasinaha. What is that? It will come. Prajatantumma Vyavachetsi. There is a mantra. Vedam Anuchya Acharya Priya Priya Dhanamahritya. Acharya Priyam Dhanamahritya. Prajatantum mavyavachetsihi. After you finish your education, give something acharyaya priyam dhanam aghritya, whatever he likes the most. See, those days you don't pay fees and then study. We have reversed the table now. Those days you study and you are so grateful to the master who imparted knowledge. No fees, nothing. The master completely takes care of you like his son or daughter. Completely takes care of you. You live with them. Antevasi. That's why it's called Antevasi. When he lives in the inner quarters. Completely taken care. Then the guru is so happy that this person is worthy for the society. Let him off into the society. Snatakotaka karya. Then vivaha. In fact, vivaha karya, if you see, you will see the first few are... nobody understands what is happening. First few are all these karyas only. Today we have added Kashi Yatra and all that in South Indian marriages and so on. But these are all done. Then what he says, when you earn, go back to the guru and say, I am because of you. And I know what you value, I will give you. I'll give you what you want. And gurus also ask very nice things. They don't ask, they are not, you know, Bitta Paharaha. They are all Chitta Paharaha. They are not with apahara. They don't take away your money. They take away your chit and make you a better person. That's why acharyaya priyam dhanam ahritya. Then what did the Veda say? Prajatantum ma vivachetsihi. Because it is only grihastashrama which will bring the world of institutions. If the whole world is only sannyasi, we will shut down the shop one day and go. That's the end of the story. Over. So grihastashrami is very, very important. So Rinasesha is also that means. It means that. Then Manusmriti, chapter 3 of Manusmriti has details. Chapter 3 of Manusmriti is on grihastashrama. Chapter 6 is on Vanaprasthashram, like that. There are nice shlokas at that. So chapter 3 is on grihastashrama. There are 8 different types of marriages. How do you do marriage? All those are the front part. Then comes about 65 shlokas later. Then what is this grihastashrami has to do? Like that, there are some shlokas. I pick 4 shlokas. Just to give you a sense of how we have conceptualized this whole thing.
Swadhyaye nitya yuktah syat daive chaiveha karmani deva karmani yuktohi bibartidam characharam.
He says, what should a grihastashrami do? Those who are in grihastashrama, well, that is the substantive part of materialism. See, our thinking was very good. What it says, acquire good knowledge first. Don't get distracted by any ways. Today it is full of distraction for our students. Whereas our system was absolutely no distraction. So it is because the young mind is like camphor. It will just like that, it will pick. That's why the 12 years, how much these people learn, modern education pale in comparison. Impossible. What those people go to a patashala, even today, whatever patashalas you see, what they learn in 12 years, we cannot go anywhere near because our model has been completely messed up. So what is our model? When you have to take education, absolutely take education. Don't get distracted. That's why they take them to a far off place. All are residential schools only. But not notorious residential schools. Good residential schools. They take them there. No distraction. Education. Then the most substantive part of life is grihastashram. But that is the only stage where you can materially acquire whatever you want to acquire. You can follow dharma, you can establish sustainability in the society, you can help the society, you can do dharma, you can help others. One man cannot even cook for himself. For a day or two, he'll get tired. So a sannyasi or brahmachari has to go to a hostel or some matha where somebody is cooking. But it is only a householder who can really hold on the society, nobody else. They are the only ones who are actually the kingpin of the society for it to. Institutions are created only through grihastashram. The institution of living also. Institution called society also. That's what he's saying. He's saying, do studies. Nitya yukta ha swadhyaye. Syat daivecha eva iha karmani. Appropriate gods. Pray to the gods. Do dharma. Dharma artha kama. Dharma artha kama is the greatest aligned activity during grihastashrama, which paves way for moksha. That is this model. It is dharma artha kama. You should have dharma, you should have artha, you should have kama. Everything in grihastashrama. So, and deva karmani yukta hahi, by doing that, characharam bibarti idam. They actually support all movable and immovable. Everything they support. Manusmriti says it is only grihastashrama which can support everything. That's what he says in that shloka. Then he says, Agno prastahuti samyak adityam upatishtate aditya jayate vrishtihi vrishte ratnam tataprajaha annam tataprajaha. He says, this grihastha, in fact, in chapter 3 of Bhagavad Gita, there is a 12th shloka. Exactly the same shloka, right? Parjanyat and annat bhavanti bhutani parjanyat anna sambhavaha yajna karma samudbhavaha. There is one shloka. That yajna is this adno. He says, by propagating the gods, which is the most important role of only a grihastashrami, because brahmachari has no rituals, sannyasi anyway has no rituals, Vanaprastha ashrami also has no rituals can be done only by grihastha ashramas, which means Vedic lore can be protected only by grihastha ashramis, not by anybody else. That is the meaning of it. So agno prastha ahutihi, the ahuti which is sent through Anna, right? Samyak adityam upatishtate. Literally, people did it. What they did in 2004, a place called Mulangunathukkal, which is about 10 kilometers from Thrissur, en route to Guruvayur. There they did, there are seven types of somayagas. One of them is called Aptaryama Somayaga, Somayagna. So after 220 years, it was done. 2004, January, 10 days. 10 days means last 2.5 days, non-stop, nobody sleeps. The Mukhya Yajamana doesn't sleep. The Somarasa and all that they take, and then non-stop, last 2 days. And every day, one layer of brick. I went there for 3 days. It was amazing to see the Vedic Yajna that they did. Aptaryama Soma Yajna. But what was interesting was, around that site, there were so many instruments. Nimans, these people, that people, you know, agricultural university, all kinds of people put a lot of instruments. So I was invited to speak. I also spoke one of the evenings. Other times I was looking at the Yajna, participating in the Yajna, and I started talking to them. And what they were doing, they are trying to find out, Yajna, if you do, rain will come. They are trying to find out. And in the, I think in Atharva Veda, it is all mentioned that if you do Yajna, how the Oshadi Vanaspatayaha, the plant kingdom, how they actually nourished. So they put machines and measuring that. So after 4 months, we had a workshop here. We all whom went there, we all again and came and spoke. So all these people came and presented their findings. They all said, yes, we found the growth was 20% more, 30%. A heavy rain on the 10th day. Massive rain on the 10th day, all that happened. So these are all today. If a cardiologist, no, today we are living in a world where a cardiologist will come and tell you there is a hole in your heart. You have complete shraddha on him. You have never seen a hole. You can't even see your heart. You can see a photo. Somebody says that is heart. You better believe it. Some black and white something bulges and then dances like this. Somebody says that is a heart. You generally believe it. Life is only on belief. So if the cardiologist says your heart has to be repaired, your valve has to be changed, all that, we believe. All these we don't believe. We want to verify it. Thank God we want to verify this. If cardiologist, there is a hole in your heart, if I start verifying my hole, I will prove it posthumously. So our Shraddha is also a little bit divided. This is what he is saying. What he is saying, you propitiate your God, it will go as rain. It will go to, you know, into the antariksha. You know, Aditya means antariksha. It gets into the atmosphere. And then Aditya Jayate Vrishtihi. See, Vrishtihi, in modern parlance, we use Vrishtihi. This is a Vedic word. Yeah, Takara, instead of Takara, it is Takara. Vrishtihi. No, it is not. It is actually, if you look at, I think, probably, if you look at, what is that? Yaskas. Nirukta. If you look at Nirukta, maybe this word, maybe that. This is a Vedic word. Valmiki has also used that word. Vrishti, not Vrishti. Means the same, rain. And then, Vrishtehe, I find it difficult to pronounce this. Vrishtehe annam tataha prajaha. Right? That's what, you know, in Brahmanandavalli Taittiriya, same thing is there. Akashat vayuhu vayor agnihi agnerapaha apyaprithivi prithivyam oshadayaha oshadibhyonnam annat purushaha savayesha purusho namayaha. All those are there. This food cycle is completely described. It is the ahuti which goes into the antariksha, which creates clouds. That comes as water. The water feeds the oshadi vanaspataya. And the plant kingdom nourishes human beings. And the human beings do the progeny. That's what he is saying. So this is done by only grihastha ashrami, nobody else. These, all these Vedic injunctions of Vedic rites of yajnas, the adhikara is only for a grihastha ashrami, not for anybody else. So Manusmriti says they are the ones who support the whole world. Huh? Yeah, yeah.
This is a Vedic usage. Yeah. Stoshtunashtuhu. That is the sutra. Takara, takara, vilukna, shakara, takara. Yata vayum samashritya vartante sarva jantavah tata grihastam ashritya vartante sarva ashrama. Beautiful example he gives. He says, yata vayum samashritya. The whole world is supported only by the air. The whole world depends on the air for survival. You have to breathe in and breathe, including the plant kingdom. It's complementary. It takes carbon dioxide and gives oxygen. We take that oxygen and give carbon dioxide. Paraspara bhava is happening anyway. He gives that example. Tata, in the same way, all other ashramas depend on grihastha ashrama. That's what he says. Tata grihastham ashritya vartante sarva ashramaha. This is the kingpin of the society. This is the prime axis of the society is grihastha ashrama. Right? Yasma trayopyashraminaha jnane nane na chanvaham grihaste neiva dharyante tasma cheshtashramo grihi. Yasmat, from whom? Trayaha ashraminaha. The other three ashramis obtain their jnana and anna. That's what he says. Jnana and anna, the knowledge and food is given only by the grihastha ashramis. Annena cha anvaham, blessed by that. Grihasthena eva daryante. They behold and support and make it happen. Otherwise, it is not possible. Grihasthena eva daryante tasma jeshta ashramaha grihi. Therefore, I am telling you, the ultimate of the ashramas is grihastha ashrama. That is why the wife is called sahadharmacharini. Dharma kshetre idi dharmasya pantanam idi agre gantavyam sahadharmacharini atyavashyaki bhavati. Dharma will not be upheld in any other ashrama. You need grihastha ashrama. So that is what Bharata is saying. So I thought I'd bring some of the smriti granthas to tell you this is a larger thing. So today it's all reduced to a 50 lakh affair, where you do some 300 food and waste about tons and tons of them, show your pomp and splendor and throw everything and go. And then I don't know what happens after that. That's not our conceptualization. For us, this boy and the girl stepping into a wedlock means they have taken a great responsibility to say that I have nourished this society. The nourishing of the society is burdened on me, on us. The Vivaha mantras are like that. But only on the day when people read Vivaha mantras, understand it, and then they get married, marriage will get a U-turn. Until then, marriage will not get a U-turn. Because we are doing mindlessly without knowing what we are doing. Great ideas are there in the Vivaha mantra. So nobody knows that. Because the Purohit keeps on shouting, you keep on shaking hands. In between he says, why don't you throw something into the altar and then you do it. That is because we don't know what is that. All these are beautifully written. The responsibilities are laid out. All that. Anyway, so we'll move on to the next sarga, 107th sarga. Now after all these 4-5 arguments, Rama advises him, go back. Right? And now, actually, Rama narrated the entire background of what happened. You know, when Kaikeyi was married, he gives two things in these 10 shlokas. When Kaikeyi was married, Rama promised to Kaikeyi's father that he will... Dasharatha promised to Kaikeyi's father that I give your daughter a kingdom. Rama recollects that. That is one. Second is that Yuddha in which he was, that also he says, because of all of that, the mother asked something and the father said that, don't mix up things. These are all fair play. For you, it may look not a fair play. They are all fair play. So don't get too much worried about that. You go back and only thing you should do is to make sure the father's debt is redeemed. What the father's debt? That is a promise to the mother. That should be redeemed. Don't try to confuse it in one way or the other. So like that, Rama explains back to Bharata. Huh? punnam no narakat yasmat pitaram trayate. If Bharata can make a blackmail, Rama also can make a blackmail. So that is what it is here. Punnam no narakat yasmat pitaram trayate sutah tasmat putra iti proktah pitrnyapati sarvatah. He says, I will define you what do you mean by a son or an offspring, basically. Putra can also be for putri. The idea is the same. Put is the naraka. Putaha trayati iti putra or putri, depending upon whoever it is. So he says, put namna narakat. Right? Yasmat pitaram trayate sutaha. That offspring which protects, which redeems the father from the naraka. Tasmat putra hai iti prakta. That's why he is called a putra. The very name putra came because putaha trayati iti putra. Pitran yappati sarvataha. Always it is the role of the son to redeem the father. By asking me to come and me coming, father's promise will go. So he is not now, he is now into a trouble. That's what Rama is now trying to give that angle to the whole thing. So he says, tasmat putra iti proktaha, pitran yaha pati sarvataha. Then he says, eshtavya bhagava putraha, gunavanto bahushutaha, vai samavetanam, api kaschid gayam brajet. So he says, one should have many child. And he says, why? Because at least one fellow will redeem. Like that, you know, Rama is saying. He's saying, Yeshtavya Bhagava Putraha Gunavantaha Bahushutaha. Well-known people have said, have more children, because if one is not doing, at least the other will do, they will redeem you. Because that Rana has to be, Rana Vimochana must happen. Tesham Vai Samavetanamapi Kaschit Gayam Rajet. They will do the ancestral thing in Gaya. Looks like that practice is very old. Going to the Gaya and then doing the Pitra Shraddha is referred in Valmiki Ramayana. He says, Kaschit Gayam Rajet. He says, maybe references of that. Then comes this Rishi Jabali, this sage Jabali. He comes and then throws such a shocking googly on the whole conversation that it is astonishing to read, actually. There may be reason why, because Vasistha says he knows all that. In the next chapter, when Rama was angry, anyway, we will see it. 18 shloka. I don't think so. I don't think it is Satyakama Jabali. No, Vasistha did not oppose or support. Rama got angry. I will see, we'll come to it. Rama got angry. Vasistha simply said, no, Jabali knows. He's saying all these only with an anxiety to bring you back to Ayodhya, something like that he says. Anyway, we will see what Jabali is all about. Jabali says, you know, in 18 shlokas, he really, you know, shatters everybody there. He talks like a charvaka, right? Charvakas are those who don't believe in God, who don't nastikavada. They think, what is there, enjoy and go. That's the end of the story. 100% materialistic, nothing more than that. Yavat jive sukam jive. Rinam krutva ghritam pibet. Today's living is like that, exactly. Credit card mechanism. This is exactly the credit card living. What does it say? Credit card economy. Yavat jive sukam jive. As long as you are there, enjoy. Enjoy madi. If I have to use the Kannada word, enjoy madi. Then he says, rinam krutva, take loan. Rinam krutva ghritam pibet. Enjoy ghee. Means you don't have wherewithal to buy. Don't worry. Use credit card. So that is the Charvaka philosophy. He brings all that philosophy actually into some shlokas in the 18th. No, I want to tell you there is so much talk about tolerance and all that. There is so much about tolerance that are people talking today. If anybody reads ancient Indian literature, you will find democracy of knowledge, democracy of opinions, democracy of, in fact, there are Shad Darshanas. Okay, we have Shad Darshanas. These Shad Darshanas are about Jiva, Jagat and Ishwara. What is the connection? Individuals are there, world is there, there is a larger force called God. Call it whatever you want. Some larger force is there, because that 99.99% science has not understood. What science understood? 0.001%. There's not. For example, today the best cardiologist can never tell you why did you get a heart attack. All answers they give for why is actually what, not why. Why did you get a heart attack? They'll say there's a block. I did ask you what caused the heart attack. I asked you why did I get a heart attack. There's a difference between what. Today's why, science, what describes as why is actually how, not why. My question is, why did somebody get a heart attack means, I ask, why did he get and not the other person? That is another one meaning. Another meaning, why did he get at 5:30? Why did he not get it at 4:30? That is another meaning for the why. Why has such meaning? Science cannot answer that. Moment you ask why, science will give an answer which is actually what or how. At least leave that. Science can never answer who. Impossible. Science cannot answer who. So what science answers is very small, but that's very useful. I'm not ridiculing science. I'm saying don't put it on a simhasana and then think that's the end of it. Charvakas do that. That's not that. Anyway, we'll see some shlokas. Kakasya purusho banduhu kimapyam kasya kena chit. Yade ko jayate jantuhu yekayeva vinashyati. He says, what is all these father, mother, other friends, relatives and all that? Yeah. You came alone, you went alone. Enjoy. That's all. That's what he's saying. Kaha kasya purushaha. Who is whose purusha? Banduhu. What is this relation? Okay. Kimapyam. Kasya kena chite, what is to be achieved from whom? To be got from whom? Nothing. Yate ekaha jayate. Ekaha jayate can be actually challenged. You have twins, you have quadruples, you have triplets, all those are that. But anyway, we didn't mean that. What I meant is, you came alone. You did not come with all your father, mother, all of them did not take, took on a bus and got into a clinic and got out of the clinic or nothing like that. You all came alone. Ekaha jayate jantuhu ekaheva vinashyati kadapi sarve vinashyanti api. We are not talking about their own accident, all of them will go. I am not talking about that. But what he is saying is, you came alone. You went alone. What is all these? You have done the father, mother, father's words, mother's words. You are wasting your time. This is what Jabali is saying. Jabali is saying that why are you wasting your time? You know where you can find a counter answer for this? If you want to find a counter answer for this, look at chapter 6 of Bhagavad Gita, last 7 shlokas. Beautifully Krishna has said, Nakaschit Kalyanakar Durgatim Tata Gachati. He starts from there. He says there is a continuity to us. You did not come here just like that, somebody's father or mother, but we already talked about it in the last class also. So what he says is actually not true. You don't just like that get born. Science cannot explain any of the real. What science cannot explain, it has discovered what is called probability. He says chance event. That's a very comfortable way of pushing everything under the carpet. If you don't know anything, you should say chance event. What is this chance here? And there is no discussion possible after that. That means chance event means you have to put a full stop.
This is true, context is wrong.
Huh?
What he says is absolutely true. Context is
wrong. No, you don't. He is not telling in a Vedantic sense. He is not telling in a Vedantic sense. Even in a Vedantic sense, I don't agree. That's why I said, go and read Bhagavad Gita. It may appear you came as though you came alone. It's not like that. You read Chandogya Upanishad. You will find out how the whole journey happens, how the soul decides where to descend. It's not just like that. It's not a roll of a die or something like that. You know, what is happening here is, this is true only in a perceptual plane. No, perceptual plane. In perception, this is true, but perception is not reality. You mean to say everything which is out of your perception doesn't exist? even in Vyavahara, this is more than Vyavahara. So, Charuvak, pleasing to the, it is nice to talk. Charuvak. Yeah. So anyway, so he says that. Then, Tasman Mata Pita Cheti Rama Sajjeta Yonaraha Unmatta Iva Sajneyaha Nasti Kaschidhi Kasyachit. Tasmat, in between there are some sloka, next sloka this, okay. Tasmat, therefore, this Mata, Pita, this father, mother, Yo Naraha Sajjeta, one who gets disturbed by all this father, mother and all, Unmatta Iva Saha. He is a lunatic. He is playing devil's advocate. Jabali is playing, he came from another angle actually, trying to see if something can work on Rama. So he says, Unmatta Iva Sajneyaha. You have to know him as a lunatic. What is all this fellow talking? You come alone, you go alone. And suddenly you were jumping up and down and say, father, mother and all, there's nothing like that. Anybody who bothers about father, mother and all that is a lunatic. That's what he is saying. Nasti kaschit hi kasyachit. There's nobody who is somebody else's. Nasti kaschit hi kasyachit. So nobody belongs to anyone. So why are you unnecessarily beating your brains like this? Your father and all gone. There's no father, mother and all that. Carry on. Enjoy. Just go on. Take it easy policy. They say, no? Take it easy policy. So you do something like that. Is what Jabali is saying in these two shlokas. I took only a few. For the whole chapter I didn't take, I only took a few. Artha dharma para ye tams tams cho chami netaran tehi dukkamiha prapya vinashyam pretya bejire. Artha dharma paraha ye. Okay? Na itaran. Right? Tan Shochami. I pity on these people who are only look at this Artha and Dharma and all that. They don't look at any other thing. They are looking at only these things. Jabali is saying to Rama. So he says, why he says, Na itaran tehi dukkam iha prapya. So what happens is, by doing all that, they ended up only with dukkha. Iha dukkam prapya. Having a lot of misery, right? Vinasham, having died, pretya, become a pretya, vejire, they don't, nothing, they get nothing out of it. So I actually pity for them. So he says, don't worry about all this dharma, arma and all that. He says, don't worry about all that. The dharma, artha and all that. See, all these are very convincing arguments. All these will fit into only one mechanism. That mechanism is, you have only one life. If you believe that you have only one life, I think many of these will work out. You make hay when the sun shines and go away. Steal, do anything because no other chance. No, you just go away, run away, finish. Whereas that one life is impossible to argue. It is impossible. My arguments are threefold. I want to ask three questions. I did some mistake. My first question is, should I be payback for my mistake? I don't think anybody is going to say no. You did something wrong, you pay back for it. Correct? So, which means, as you sow, you have to get. Now, that may not work in one janma. I'll tell you why. Even if you agree that I did a mistake, I have to be punished. The queue is very long. Counter close before that. Suppose, the queue is long for punishment. I am standing. Even before my turn came, counter closed means I have gone. What I mean is my counter is closed. Now there is a problem, no? People can get away now. Because by the time the punishment was given back to me, I have run away. I escaped through death. So to me, this is imperfect. That's not possible. Now you have to foolproof this second possibility. Then there's a third possibility. Third possibility is I did a mistake and you get a punishment. That's again not a fair system. If I did a mistake, I should only get a punishment, not somebody else. Then the whole thing will become a chaos. Therefore, the next janma, I cannot be somebody else. If I get a punishment, I should be the same. So if you take all these together, you will actually find that punarjanma is a very fundamental requirement for any reasonable thing. See, the one janma, one judgment day, I don't get at all impressed by that. My favorite example again is in a village, festival, one fellow puts one cloth. He puts one soap, one pencil, one pen, and he gives you 3 rings. He never gave you 1 ring. He gave you 3 rings for 10 rupees. First time you try, it doesn't fall. Second time you improve it a little bit. Maybe the third time you got. For a soap, if you are given 3 chances, give me 3 chances here at least. If you make a mistake, give me one more chance for me to improve. So if you look at all that, punarjanma is the sound footing on which this society lives. The motivation for me to be truthful is only because I cannot escape from the clutches of dharma. Whereas all these will work only if it is one chance you can run away. That's the end of the story. Before people catch you, run away. Over. Or to say, I'll catch and give you punishment is unfair. You please give me a second chance. This judgment day, which Semitic religions are saying, is very illogical. Why are you not giving me one more chance here? I want to learn. Don't you think if I make a mistake, should I not learn again? Why are you putting a system in which, no, I'll give you one chance. That's it. You had luck, you are okay. If you are not luck, I'll punish you. All those are illogical. For that, it will work. Not for us.
Very interesting to explain that. Because most of the thinking, India happened because we have rivers, rains and all that. So man could think. But most of the Semitic regions are in land where there is no water.
Okay.
So it's very harsh. So they believe in a complete cutoff. There's a lot of research that happens. So they don't believe in the... Because there's no time to think. It's like fight, kill, get your next meal. Because it's so harsh. The climatic conditions don't
possibly
allow for this kind of sound thinking at all.
Yedi, look at another thing which he ridicules. Yedi buktamihan yena dehamanyasya gacchati dadyat pravasatam shraddham natat patyashanam bhavet. See, you pay some money through, there is one flood which happened in Kerala. Or, calamity is now, Fani and things like that. Then they put Chief Minister's relief fund and this and all that. On what basis do we give money? There is no way you know what happened to your money. Please understand. 1 in 1,000,000 may know. If you are the one who collected the money, who are the one who went to the site, and then today people are taking pains to do all that. Why? Because our Shraddha and Dharma came down. That's why we are doing all this. He's saying, you give food through your Ahuti. How it will go to your ancestors? Don't waste your food like that. That's what he's saying here. It is disbelief and ashraddhata. He says, Yadi buktam iham anyena. Somebody else is eating. Yadi buktam iham anyena, deham anyasya gachati. Somebody is eating and it goes to your pitrus. He was ridiculing the shraddha karyam actually. Okay? Now, simple common sense. We don't need dharma and all that. We have a simple intuitive thinking. Okay, the intuitive thinking is, if I take care of somebody, poor child, something, there is the intuitive thinking, my offspring will be good. It's a very intuitive thinking. I take care of someone, there must be a larger principle of goodness, which will make sure that if some trouble happens to my children tomorrow, these are all the real motivating reasons why we want to be dharmic. Right? Now, we extend that logic is the Shraddha Karya. And in fact, our Rig Veda's first mantra says, Agnimi ile purohitam yajnasya deva ritvijam hotaram ratna datam. It says, Agni is your purohit, Agni is your courier, Agni is your ahuti is that. He is the receiver, he is the sender and all that. These are all matters of Shraddha. If you remove the Shraddha out of it, life is very challenging, right? But this intuitive feeling brings a lot of goodness in our way of living. So he is ridiculing that. He says, oh, somebody is eating, how will it go to your... just because you said this, a good amount of annadana is happening. Even that goodness will go out of the system now. If you start suspecting all these... They are very nice system to create a very nice dharmic society. So he says, Yadi Bhuktam Iham Anyena, Deham Anyasya Gichati. Okay? Then he says, Dadyat Pravasatam Shraddham Natat Patya Ashanam Bhavet. So these, all these, what you give in Shraddha will not become his food for his journey. All those don't, you don't have. He is ridiculing this notion of father, mother, ancestral things, sense of respect. All those are not required. Well, you came alone, you go alone, enjoy and then go. So it's like this, there are 18 shlokas. He really shook in the conversation. He threw really different types of shlokas into it.
Sanasti parimityeva kuru buddhim mahamate paramityeva kuru buddhim mahamate pratyaksham yattadatishta paroksham prishtatakuru.
Proper charvaka philosophy. Pratyaksham yat tat atishta. Get on to that, what you can see. All that you cannot see, prishtataha kuru. Paroksham prishtataha kuru. All that you cannot see doesn't exist. This is a simpleton thinking. I don't even call it scientific thinking. This is just simpleton thinking. Because what is not there is not there. What I cannot see is not there. Scientific progress would have never happened. You brought a telescope of a very high resolution, started seeing which you did not see. Why? You felt that there is something more than I see. You didn't end by saying what I saw is all that is. There is no world outside of what I can see. It's unscientific, actually speaking. But he is saying that pratyaksham yat tat atishta. Get on to that. Right? Paroksham prushtatakuru. Throw all that which is not there, are not there. Don't waste your time. Father is gone. That's the end of the story. Forget it. Take it out of your... That's what he is saying. Right? Sanasti param iti eva kuru buddhim mahamate. Right? That param, the next world is... Don't believe on the next world and all that. That's what he is saying. No, if all that they are saying is antithesis to all that I knew in the name of accounting that I learnt and I teach here. The first principle of running an organization is what is called going concern. Because it is a going concern, you have profit and loss account and balance sheet and so on. He is removing all those concepts by saying, they are all nice Vedantic concepts according to me. Anyway, so he says, just look at what is in front of you, all others you ignore. Forget it. They're all gone. Move on. These are all the part of this Charvaka philosophy. I think for everything we can give a counter answer. It will become very long. Already I have spoken too much on this. We just... 109th Sarga. Rama is a beautiful Sarga in which he extols truth. He blasts, comes back and heavily blasts on only truth. Satyasya Panta. Right? Nanyapanta Vidyate Ayana Satyameva. Beautifully he brings that in these 39 shlokas. Of course, in the first 39 shlokas. In the last 9 shlokas, he admonishes Jabali also. He said, don't talk all this. I don't agree with what you are talking. He really gave him back, I didn't like what you were talking and that kind of thing also he did. But there are some beautiful shlokas in Satya because again in Sanatana Dharma, I mean, we rightfully took the emblem, took the thing Satyameva Jayate from Mundaka Upanishad and put it into our national emblem and then we rested in peace. That's what we did. But Satya is extolled very well in many of our scriptures actually and our Upanishads and so on. So what is Rama saying? Kulinam akulinam va viram purushamaninam charitrameva vyakhyati shuchim va yadi va shuchim. He says, how do you judge a person? Whether he is a kulinaha, akulinaha, bhavatu. Whatever he is. Right? Whether he is a high born or a low born. Vira purushaha maninam. Right? Person with honor or dishonor and otherwise, right? Shuchimba, ashuchimba, whether he is clean or unclean, all those are decided by his charitra. Means what he left behind, what he did, not what he spoke. Because, Lord, see, we have this practical problem in this country. You look at any congregation, we will at length talk about how corruption is very, very bad. Asmakam charitram tadrishamna. When it comes to you, pay some 100 rupees and then go. That's called charitra. What is your charitra? Rama says, all these are dictated by how you actually behaved in your life situations. How did you react to life situations? Father left something, you are all jumping. He said something, that's the end of the story. And Pitruvakya Paripalanam is the charitra. So he says, you will be dictated by the charitra, not by all your degree. And all. That's why here today, the biggest problem I see in modern education is very well educated people are sometimes immoral to the core. Big frauds are done by people who are educated well. So education and all that is now little bit delinked now. The charitra is different from the education. He says, you keep whatever you want. I look at the charitra. Charitra meva vyakhyati. You are determined by your charitra. Okay? Then he says, kama vritta stvayam lokaha krishna samupavartate yad vritta santi rajanaha tad vritta santi hi prajaha yadyat acharati sreshtaha tadyat eva itarejanaha sayat pramanam krute lokastha danuvartate. Krishna says in third chapter of Bhagavad Gita, same thing he is saying here. Yata raja tata praja. That's what he is saying. Yat vrittaha santi rajanaha tat vrittaha santi hi prajaha. Indeed, prajas will only follow. So if your charitra is not good, you will not find that people will be any better. That's why, you know, these politicians and all, if they behave so badly, every institution will behave like that. But they look upon them. You can do whatever you want and get away with any amount of corruption and all that. The society will hugely deteriorate. Because that's what people will look at. What Rama is saying is, here is an opportunity for us to show to the society what do we believe in. But there are 2-3 occasions where Rama was accused. When it comes to it, we will bring it. Why did he kill Vali? Why did he ask Sita to go onto the fire and come back? There are deeper things are there. Today they are all, you know, saying different things. If you are heading an institution, people look at you very, very, very carefully. So you have to make some personal sacrifices to establish and to protect the institution for long, long times to come. You have to make huge personal sacrifices. That's only for the leader's problem, not the ordinary person's problem. That's why he's saying, yad vrittaha santi rajanaha, tad vrittaha santi hi prajaha. Kama vrittastvayam lokaha krishnaha samo. Everywhere people have conduct itself as per their own sweet will. That's why they look at something and then they will do what they want to do. So you have to project properly. Otherwise it will be in trouble.
Satyameva nrisham samcha rajavrittam sanatanam tasmat satyatmakam rajyam satyeloka pratishtitaha.
He says there are 3 lakshanas for rajavritti. If you want to be the head of a country, right? He says satyam, right? Anrishamsam, compassion, no violence. You have to be very compassionate. Okay? Rajavrittam sanatanam. He says truth and non-violence are the perpetual principles of kings. Sanatanam rajavrittam. Okay? Therefore, tasmat satyatmakam rajyam. Right? It should be embodiment of truth. If you waver from that, the effect will be very catastrophical. We may not be able to understand it, how it will happen. Satyatmakam rajyam, satye loka pratishtha. The stability of the world critically hinges on truthfulness. Satye lokaha pratishtitaha. That's what he says to Bharata.
Satyam eveshwaro loke, satyam dharma sadashritaha. Satyamulani sarvani satyanasti parampadam.
He says, Ishwara, satyameva Ishwaraha lokaha. The Lord at the end, that's why truth alone triumphs. Triumphs at the end. Satyameva jayate is not known by tomorrow morning. This concept that truth alone triumphs, sometimes it takes generation to see how it actually undoes an untruth. Our life, our time of 30, 40, 50 years are nothing. It is a speck of dust actually. Truth is, Adi Shankara's definition of truth, the Vedantic definition of truth is that which will not change in the past, today and future. That is what the meaning of truth. If anybody changes it, it will restore it back. But it may take time. He says, Loke Ishwaraha Satyam. The Lord of the Lordship of the whole world is Satyam. Dharmaha Sada Satya Ashritaha. The Dharma is inextricably linked to Satyam. Truthfulness is the other side of the coin called Dharma. Okay? Satya Moolani Sarvani. The fundamental kernel of every existence is Satya. If you touch it, Sarvanashaha Bhavati. Okay? Satyat Nasti Param Padam. There is no other path other than being truthful. People don't understand it, will pay a heavy price if they are untruthful. They may not see it now. There is no rule. You have to see some things you will see immediately. Some things you will see after Janmas. Something you will see later. Satya will not, it flows unilaterally in a particular way. So that is what he is bringing. He is saying all these, by me coming back, we would have created an asatya of father's thing. That will be sorted out. Even if you do it, something else will happen. It will get sorted out. That's the point he is coming to. That is sat. Soham pitur nidesham tu kimartam nanu palaye satya pratishravas satyam satyena samayi kritam. Our father, true to his promise, he promised. We discussed all this so beautifully in the first part of Ayodhya Kanda, if you remember this dilemma of who is right. In Sarga 12 to 16, when we saw Ayodhya Kanda, we discussed it in great detail. I was trying to argue that I analyzed each character. Was Dasharatha right? Was Kaikeyi right? Was Rama right? If you remember. That is the point. He says, what father did was right. Satyena, samayikritam, satya pratishravaha sahaham, right? Why would I not protect? Why would I not do anupalana of that? Why are you getting confused? All these are done with a fair amount of truthfulness, and father promised, she extracted the promise, I gave the promise. Why are we unnecessarily, rattling it back and forth? There was nothing wrong it might have been an uncomfortable thing for me. For in the eyes of the people, it may look as though I have been disadvantaged. No, I don't think like that. He gave a promise, he kept his promise. The fallout of that, we will have to faithfully follow. That is called satya. That's what he's saying. Pituhu nirdesham tu kimartam nanupalaye. Why would I not do it? Aham soham satya pratishravaha. I am committed to satya. And what a father did was satya. So I will not, wander from here and there. That's what Rama is saying. Naiva lobanna mohadva nahyajnana tamonvitaha setum satyasya betsyami guroho satya pratishravaha. I will not break the bridge of satya. Setum, right? Na betsyami, that's what he says. Guroho, fathers. Okay? Out of loba, out of greed, out of moha, delusion, out of ajnana, lack of knowledge, I will not do that. Out of ignorance or out of tamas, illusion, lack, complete absence of knowledge, I will not do that. I am absolutely clear that this bridge that the father made bridge to truthfulness for himself, that bridge, I will not break those bridges. It's not going to work. You are seeing it in a slightly different way. And then he says, asatya sandasya sataha chalasya stira chetasaha naiva devana pitaraha priti chanti ti nashrutam naha shrutam by us. Naha is we, by us. Asatya sandasya is somebody who is actually committed to non-truthfulness. Untruthfulness. Asatya satya sandahana. Asatya sandaha. Asatya sandasya. Okay. Sataha. Satascha. Chalasya astira chetasaha. That asatya sanda is a shaking and unstable cheta, mind. Okay. Naiva devaha na pitaraha ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಇಚ್ಛಂತಿ, ಪ್ರತಿ ಇಚ್ಛಂತಿ, ಪ್ರತಿ ಇಚ್ಛಂತಿ, ಪ್ರತಿ ಇಚ್ಛಂತಿ ಇತಿ ನಹ ಶ್ರುತಂ. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಡನ್ ಅನ್ಟ್ರೂತ್ಫುಲಿ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಬೈ ಎನಿಬಡಿ, ನ ದೇವಾಸ್ ನ ಪಿತರ ನ ನಾಟ್ ಬೈ ಅವರ್ ಆನ್ಸೆಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನಥಿಂಗ್, ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ವ್ಯರ್ಥ. ಡೋಂಟ್ ಡೂ ದಟ್. ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಸ್ ದ ಓ ಆಫ್ ಸತ್ಯ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟೆಡ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ದಟ್, ನೋ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ Rama, it's a very powerful sarga in which I took only some shlokas. So I just want to give a few Upanishadic quotations because this is being discussed quite a bit. So this is in Mahanarayana Upanishad. Mahanarayana Upanishad, last three mantras are pinnacle of the whole discussion, 78, 79, 80. So I have taken from 78th mantra and 79th mantra. Look at this. It says, ಸತ್ಯಂ ಪರಂ ಪರಗುಂ ಸತ್ಯಗುಂ ಸತ್ಯೇ ನನಸು ಅರ್ಗಾಲ್ಲೋಕಾ ಚ್ಯವಂತೇ ಕದಾಚನ ಸತಾಗುಂ ಹಿ ಸತ್ಯಂ ತಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಸತ್ಯೇ ರಮಂತೆ. ಸತ್ಯಂ ಪರಂ, ಸತ್ಯಂ ಇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್, ಪರಂ ಸತ್ಯಂ ಇಟ್ ರಿವರ್ಸಸ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ದ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ರೂತ್. Truth is ultimate. The ultimate is truth. Satyena naha swargaha lokachyavante. The only way to attain bliss is only through truthfulness. Tasma satye ramante. That's why everybody wants to be committed to truthfulness. So that's the only way you can attain bliss. That's what in Mahanayana Upanishad is called jnana nirupana. The last three are leading to the ultimate jnana in which it is coming. The 79th mantra is called Prajapati Aruni Vidya. Prajapati and his son Aruna, they have a conversation. It's a beautiful conversation. He asks, you know, what is ultimate, in which it again comes. So I will take that also. Satyena Vayura, Satyena Vayura Vati, Satyena Dityo Rochate, Divi Satyam Vacha Pratishta. ಸತ್ಯೇ ಸರ್ವಂ ಪ್ರತಿಷ್ಠಿತಂ ತಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಸತ್ಯಂ ಪರಮಂ ವದಂತಿ. ಸತ್ಯೇನ ವಾಯುರಾವಾತಿ, ದಿಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಭೀಷಾಸ್ಮಾತ್ ವಾತಃ ಪವತೆ ಭೀಷೋದೇ ಇತಿ ಸೂರ್ಯ. ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಚೈತ್ರೋಪನಿಷತ್. ದೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಯರ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಫಿಯರ್. ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. ಮೃತ್ಯುರ್ ಧಾವತಿ ಪಂಚಮ ಇತಿ, ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್. ಸತ್ಯೇನ ದಿ ವಿಂಡ್ ಬ್ಲೋಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸತ್ಯ. ವಾಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್? ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೂತ್ಫುಲ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಅನದರ್. ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್. ಇಫ್ ಸನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ 1 centimeter ಹಿಯರ್, ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ ಬಿ ಬರ್ಂಟ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಸೇಸ್. ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಸನ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಅ ಮೀಟರ್ ಅವೇ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅಸ್, ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ ಡೈ ಆಫ್ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್. They are all working on Satya Sankalpa. There is a principle of Satya. See, sun and moon are reduced today by science as some gases, some carbon dioxide and all these kinds of nonsense. They are not. Why? Because if sun gets up and 6 billion, if 6 billion species are energized by one entity, gives life to 6 billion species, how can that entity which gives life will be lifeless? It has to be embodiment of life. Science does not know all that. So it looks at like it's all nothing but the physics. And the day we understood water as two molecules of hydrogen and oxygen, our problem started. Whereas our ancestors said, Yopam pushpam veda, pushpavan prajavan pashuman bhavati. Yeah, apam pushpam veda, pushpavan prajavan bhavati. Water is no longer seen as water. It is seen as H2O. Then you have no abhimana for it. That's why so much of pollution, so much of udasina bhava. They are all devas for us. We should have respect for them. So it says, satyena vayuravati. The air, the vayu bhagavan blows because of satya sankalpa. Satyena aditya. The sun rises exactly at a particular time and sets exactly at a particular time, happening for time immemorial because of satya sankalpa. Okay? Divi satyam vachaha. In fact, the speech, the faculty of speech is fired by this thing of satya. Imagine the whole world starts talking lies. Life is very challenging. You cannot believe anything, and the whole world is very challenging, actually speaking. Right? Satyam vacha pratishtita. In speech resides truth. Okay? Satye sarvam pratishtitam. The whole world resides in this concept called satya. Tasma satyam paramam vadanti. That's why satya is ultimate. This is Prajapati Aruni Vidya in which it is coming. One more I will take from Mundakopanishad. It's already 6 o'clock, but I'll take one and then stop there. This is our national emblem, so I have to take this. Satyameva jayate nanritam. Satyena panta vitato devayanaha. Yena kramantirshayo hyaptakamaha. Yatra tat satyasya paramam nidhanam. He says, Satyameva jayate nanritam. What will win is only truth. Untruth will not win. It will win in the short run, but it will pay back with interest. Heavy interest is like the, you know, usur, you know, it's a very heavy interest actually. People who tread away from the path of Dharma will heavily pay for it. From Satya will heavily pay for it. They may not know when they will pay. Because this is all, you know, all encompassing stability that God has created. So, Satyameva jayate nanritam, Satyena panta vitato devayanaha. All those great people who went, the divine people who went, they tread the path of Dharma, Satya. Okay? Satyena panta vitato devayanaha. Yena akramantya rishayaha. Hi apta kamaha. They are free of desires. Kama is over for them. Once they are beyond desires, what was the path they took? They took yena. Yena akramantya rishayaha. Apta kamaha. Yatra tat satyasya paramam nidanam. Where did they reach? The ultimate abode they reached is nothing but satya. They reached unto satya. So satyam is ultimate. In fact, every Upanishad that is there. I just took only two Maganarayan Upanishad. Vishos, Madhvatapavate is in Taittiriya Upanishad. In every Upanishad you can find. That we have strongly believed in. So Rama reminded all these to Bharata. He said, don't get carried away by short-term temptations in life. Today you are not happy. You want to fix things. You want to fix things for your convenience. Satya is on enveloping. It will not leave you. It will fix everything. So a wise person must actually align to Satya. So that is the counter argument he made. And then Vasishtha came. There's one more Sarga. In the next Sarga, what he did was, Vasishtha came now. Vasishtha, what he did was, he actually from Brahma, from the Srishti, up to Dasharatha, he gave the list that we already saw in Balakanda. It comes again. He gave the entire Ikshvaku Kulasya, Nyatayanam, the ancestral. And then he said, see Rama, all of them, elder son actually ascended the throne. Please ascend the throne. You are the elder son. So that's what is the next sarga. So I'm not going to discuss that sarga because it's only a list of names which we already showed it in Balakanda. And Rama is going to reply for that once again. That we will see in the next Sunday. I'm not here, I'm traveling. Probably we will have the class the following Sunday. We will say the Swasti Prajabhya Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahim Mahishaha Gobramhanebhyo Shubhamastu Nityam Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Kale Varshatu Parjanyaha Prithivi Sasya Shalini Deshoyam Kshobarahito Brahmana Santu Nirbhaya Aputra Putrina Santu Pautrinaha Adhana Sadhana Santu Jivantu Sharadam Shatam Shrinvan Ramayanam Bhaktya Yappadam Padame Bhava Sayati Brahmanastanam Brahmana Pujyate Sada Harihi Om.